This is Denver Riddle, host of Color Grading Central. I'm excited to bring you a tutorial on how to work with video that's been captured in the RAW CinemaDNG format on the Blackmagic camera. Specifically, I'm going to share with you the workflow on how to edit and on how to color grade the original CinemaDNG files in DaVinci Resolve. The challenge with CinemaDNG files is that they can't be edited natively in nonlinear editors. So how we can address this is first by transcoding the files using Resolve into a format that the editor can use, perform the edit, and then bring the project back to Resolve where we can relink to the original CinemaDNG files and perform raw color grading of the finished edit. I know this sounds complicated, but it's actually quite easy to do, and it really only adds one additional step to your typical workflow. In this video tutorial, I'm going to share with you a step-by-step guide on how to accomplish this, and I'm going to do it all in under 5 minutes. In my Finder here, on the Mac or on the PC, I have folders containing the CinemaDNG files. Each folder here represents a video clip, and going into the folders, you can see that the video is nothing more than a still sequence similar to a TIFF or DPX sequence. So to begin handling these, I'll come over here to Resolve, and then in the Media page, I'll locate those same folders. And now it shows the CinemaDNG sequence as a single video clip. If I click on one, I can scrub through it to preview it. When I'm ready to import a clip, I can add it to the media pool by double-clicking on it. Give me just a moment while I add the remaining clips. By the way, the clips you see here are from the short film Ascend, and you can learn more about the film and download some of the footage by clicking the links below. Okay, now we're ready to move on. If I go to the color page, I can perform a first light color correction to the footage or apply a Rec. 709 LUT. I'm just showing you this as an option, but nothing we actually do here is final. It's just that some editors and directors prefer to have pleasing media to look at as opposed to muddy flat looking images. Now, it's a really good idea at this point to save our project, so let me just do that. Okay, now we're ready to generate proxies, or the transcoded format that our nonlinear editor can use. Going to the Deliver page, I'll use the easy setup and choose Export to Final Cut Pro as my starting point. We'll choose this option regardless of the actual editor we'll be using. So this also goes for Adobe Premiere, AVID Media Composer, and Final Cut X. Okay, now we'll choose our format and codec. I personally like to go with ProRes 422LT, but you can choose any format and codec that works for you. Now I'll just need to choose a destination, click OK, and I want these to be added to their own separate folder, so I'll create a folder called Proxies by typing it in the subfolder field. I need to make sure that all the clips are selected to be rendered out, so let me do that. Okay, now we're ready. I'll click Add Job, and then Start Render. I've sped it up so you can see the finish. And now we have proxies that we can work with. We can verify this by going to the Finder and finding our proxies in the Proxies folder that we've just created. Okay, now over here in Final Cut X, we'll import the proxy clips. Again, it doesn't matter which program you use to edit with, so long as you can send the edit back to Resolve with an AAF, EDL, or XML. So just for demonstration purposes, I'll perform a mock edit, shortening some of these down, and moving them around. Once the edit is complete and we have a locked picture, we can send it back to Resolve for final color grading. To do that, I'm going to create an XML by going to File, then Export XML. I'll leave everything the way it is, and click Save. Now going back to Resolve, I'll go to the Conform page, and import the XML by going to File, then Import AAF EDL XML. Navigate to the recently saved XML, and click Open. Now we're presented with a prompt. Now this part is really important. We need to uncheck the Automatically Import Source Clips checkbox. This will ensure that the edit will relink to the original CinemaDNG files and not to the proxies. It's a good idea before we do all this that we already have the CinemaDNG files imported, so that way the XML will know which files to point to. So now we'll click OK. And now we have our finished edit that's relinking to the original CinemaDNG files, and now we can begin raw color grading. Up next, in the next tutorial, we'll cover how to color grade RAW CinemaDNG files to get really pleasing results. I guarantee it. And if this video tutorial is helpful and you'd like to see more on the Blackmagic camera, please like it and add a comment. Thanks for watching.